Okay, one second. We're back with Sorry, what is it? Deadly Tower Monsters. The movie hasn't started yet. I want to see something. Wait. Oh, hey, it's just normal.
Well, I see you dug up the original movie poster.
Oh.
Oh boy, that takes me back. All right, we're gonna start the commentary track now.
All right. I'm playing for an hour and 30 minutes. Jeez. It's really not that long, actually. Oh, get out of here, Chrome. Sorry, I'm turning on the timer right now. Yeah, it's only like a minute off. Oh my god. Checkpoint before an elevator. Excuse me. Don't ruin the sanctity of the elevators. Woohoo! Whip, whip. Oh, wait. Dang it. What am I supposed to do? Oh, do I go in here? No. Oh, no. Let's just go back. I think I need to change characters. To her, maybe? Yeah. Oh, yeah, because I got a power for her. Oh, yeah, I didn't think I mentioned this. It's kind of obvious now, but it's a, Deadly Tower Monsters is a top-down, like, kind of like, game. Top-down, kind of. It's kind of like a top-down game, yeah. Not really, but kind of. It's a top-down, like, shooter, beat-em-up type game. I guess is what you would call it. And, going up this Deadly Tower Monsters, and it's like this really, like, you know, like, the set, like, old movies? It's like old, it's like playing like an old sci-fi movie. And that's amazing. So I love it. Cause I love the old sci-fi movies.
We're about at the altitude where Dick's rocket ship had crash landed at the start of the film. When I think back about all the work we did, building this darn tower and making models and costumes and sets and props, and then trying to keep it all straight during filming and not get anything all mixed up. It's exhausting. Just thinking
really
back on it is exhausting. I wish I could tell my younger self to just direct romantic comedies.
Oops.
It's the only way you'll get a good night's sleep.
Romantic comedies.
Yes, the rotating contraption things. We actually used Ferris wheel parts from an old amusement park. I think it was called Dizzyland.
Dizzyland? Isn't that kind of close to...
Yeah, and the courts agreed with you. They shut them down before they opened the gates.
Well, it's their own fault, I guess.
Well, naturally, my production team swooped right in and
bought
up everything they could get their hands on.
See, like, got quiet. Okay, I have the epic longsword and the energy whip at the sinister side. I like the energy whip, though, because...
So, I guess there was a silver lining to their legal battles. One man's lemon is another man's lemonade. Or however that saying goes.
What? I like the laser gun. I'll keep it. Let's try out the laser gun. I do want my revolver. Okay, upgrade. Can I upgrade the whip yet? Hello. Upgrade. Dang it! I need more stupid silver gears. Ooh.
Fun fact, the statue of the Emperor is actually as big as it looks on screen.
Really?
Yeah, we were going to use a small model and green screen it, but then Greg offered to fund building a life-size version. He was planning on setting it up front and center of his used car lot. Apparently, he ran into some issues with zoning laws. Yeah, I told him he should just play dumb and put the thing up anyway, but he wouldn't listen. I guess that's why he's still running that same lot. Whereas I've been barred from filming in 12 different states.
You've been barred from filming in 12 different states? Dude. That's not like an accomplishment, you know. This game has humor. I like it. It's a game I want to play. I want to play Maze. It's on the PC, but I can make it work. I do really want to play it.
If I told you how much gold paint we used on these darn sets, you wouldn't believe me. We were originally trying to decorate this whole set in precious stones. I wanted that sparkling effect, but then my props guy shook his head. I've learned that when he shakes his head, it's best to go with Plan B.
Really?
Fortunately, Plan B meant a cement mixer filled with gold paint. It was so much hard work, even I had to finally roll up my sleeves, dive in, and call some interns from the community college. Man, there's nothing college kids won't do for free pizza.
I will work on a bad sci-fi movie for free. These things are, that'd be fun. Boop. I mean, interns is free labor, but okay, get them. Oh, geez, they're coming from normal too. Get out of here. Ah. No.
Seeing the action in this scene reminds me of a big fight I had with the studio head. Word to the wise, when the guy funding your movie offers you a suggestion, stupidest idea ever is a phrase you should shy away from.
Really? Interesting. Sure about that? What if it is a stupid idea, though? She's not gonna say anything? Probably, but it's probably smart to just not say anything, even if it is a stupid idea. Because you do need funding, so. But one scene can ruin a movie. So, you know, gotta be careful with that. Yeah! Alright, well, things going smoothly, 7 minutes in, as long as my audio is actually working. From like a ton of videos, then my audio is not working, so I'm like, oh, dang it. Nah, it probably just goes back. I just go back down, right? On the computer, at least. I filmed a couple videos. Not a ton, but a good amount. Had some Christmas stuff.
I have come here to end your empire and free these apes from your tyranny.
You? Tell me. Do you think I need these pitiful creatures to run my empire?
I don't know, man.
Allow me to show you something.
Oh, cupcakes.
As you can see, I do not need those darn dirty,
darn dirty apes.
It is a kindness that I allow them to survive. I give them work so they believe their life has purpose. All I truly want from them is their gold.
Gold? Ha! What gold?
Have you not seen the result of Gregoria's planet-wide radiation? When living beings die, Their bodies are transmuted into solid gold. The apes are useless. I send my minions to harvest more gold for my empire.
You are a cruel, heartless monster.
Nah, it's called business.
Perhaps.
Oh, duh, he has weird rocket chairs. Alright. Let me hit this checkpoint. Oop, checkpoint. The Emperor's throne. Okay. Foo. What's this? New skills available. Increases melee weapon damage, increases energy regeneration. Speed. Max 5 upgrade. Melee weapon damage. Where's all the silver cogs? I don't know why I sound like a shoot.
That scene always makes me woozy. Hey, Patrick, I think we need a break.
How many levels are there? 65. I'm about halfway. Looks like it. Follow the yellow metal road. That's not the yellow metal road. Follow the yellow metal road. It's like the yellow brick road. Ooh.
You imagine one of those on your average elevator? Still, it's even worse when you press all the buttons on a real elevator. People get so annoyed when you do that.
Boom. Goodbye. Oh.
Nowadays, we just click, click, and make all this in 3D with those computers or something.
No or something.
Here. No, heck no. I still don't know how to work one of those damn contraptions.
You know how to use a computer bed? Get out of here. Oh, no. Alright, automatic teleports me. That's nice. The mecha chameleon. Now what? Oh. It's okay. Nope. No one likes a party pooper. Oh crap. Well then. No one likes a sucker. Guess what I am? Pretty big sucker, so. Hope you don't care. Not like a sucker, like, but I just suck. I'm just not overly good at most games.
Set construction 101. To make it look nice, you gotta make it look shiny. That's the secret ingredient, you know.
Shine. You know, I think you're right. What's your name? Dan or something? Dan, you should make a... Goodbye. No one likes a cranky mech chameleon.
15 production babies while making this movie. One of them was even named after one of the characters, Maximilian J. Peterson.
What? Pew, pew, pew. Okay. Got him. Now let's go. Oh, oh, there's a thing. Ooh. Am I supposed to be doing something? Okay. All right. That's rude. Do I have silver? How many silver gears do I have? Two. Suck. Wait, what am I supposed to be? So I'm supposed to dodge the boss. His attacks. Oh, I didn't know his saw would come down to that. I had to. Please tell me he doesn't take too much. Oh, what? Isn't that a shield? Looks like a shield to me. That. Ow! Okay, is it a, yay, it's a three hit thing. Oh. And it's one of these again.
Always wanted to go skydiving myself, but I have a crippling fear of heights.
Wow, really? So was this movie your way of tackling that fear head on?
Nah, this movie is what gave me my fear of heights. By the end of it, I was directing scenes with my eyes closed to keep from getting panic attacks.
Oh my god.
Now it's all starting to make sense.
Get the light out of him. He broke the mecha dome. It's not a mecha dome, whatever, but you know what I mean. So much glass to clean, and I'm the one who has to keep this tidy. I wouldn't be so bad if not for all the dinosaurs. Oh, I like the name. Ha, hilarious.
Rats! First you destroyed my Mechamillion, now you shattered the Dinodrome. Now they all escape. Do you have any idea how difficult it will be to recapture them all?
No, not really, yeah.
Julia, why is my dinosaur army running amok? Oh, well, let them roam the island.
But, Your Eminence, for them to trample on some of my hybrid specimens. That would be like turning Gregor Mendel's pea garden into soup and forcing him to drink it.
Mendel Schmendel, Doctor. I gave you gold to spawn me a dinosaur army, and I expect my army to kill things.
Good point.
But whatever you command, it is so hard to real science under these conditions.
So, wait. I'm gonna use the whip because the whip is still farther range. And it's still only two hit. So, it's still fast. Actually, it's one hit on smaller dinosaurs. Hey, guess what, rocket launcher? I know, that's what I thought. You thought you could beat me? Well, think again, rocket launcher.
The stop motion team was so stellar, and they worked for peanuts. They really did. I just couldn't get enough of them. The script called for a lot of dinosaurs here, so I said, hey, let's set the record. I told the team I wanted a minimum of 30. Of course, we found out later we were absolutely nowhere near the world record. But I didn't have the heart to tell them. I made them eat some fake plaques and sent them their way.
Aw, he's so nice. What you do for your crew? Lie to him about world records? Yes. But you know, you gotta make him happy. So, they're not gross beasts in real life, but you know, space ones might be. We don't know about space dinosaurs. Space dinosaurs could always be all ferocious, you know.
Oh, okay, now you can stop. No need to go further.
Nope, too late. Too late, buddy. Brought this upon yourself. Ooh, silver gear, finally. Or cog.
If you break even a single egg.
So, I hope you're enjoying this episode, this series, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.